Hello and welcome to this free mandolin lesson. Over the next 10 or 12 minutes, we're going to be learning a song by one of my favourite artists, and actually someone who's been hidden in every single Mando mic video for the last 2 years. He's hidden up here. It is, of course, the great Willie Nelson, and we're going to be learning his song, On the Road Again. I've put him here so he can watch over us today to make sure we're learning this properly. We're going to look at the chords, and we're going to have a jam along with his original. We're going to stick in his original key, and that will hopefully sound a bit like this. Just can't wait. G#7. F#minor. A, B. And then we're also going to learn the guitar solo, and we're going to sort of do an advanced double stop arrangement of it, which will hopefully sound a bit like this. Everything we talk about in this lesson is included in a free PDF, so you can get all the charts and tabs for everything I talk about. Just click on the link below. So let's look at the chords first. So we're in the key of E, and this song is a great example of how the closed A shape can be so useful for playing difficult chords. So the closed A shape is this one, 2-2-4-5. Now you have to remember two rules with this chord. Whatever note your little finger, pinky finger, is playing is the root. And if your middle finger is down, it's a minor chord. If your ring finger is down, it's a major chord. Or the opposite is true as well. If you need a major chord, you put your ring finger down. If you need a minor chord, you put your ring finger down. There's also a seventh chord hidden in this one, where you keep your ring finger, we lose the high note, and you tuck your middle finger on the third fret. So you've got three chords all within the same shape, all easy to access. When you look at the chords to On the Road Again, you see that you need five chords. You need E, G#7, F#minor, A and B. And there's other ways of playing it, but I think this is a great example of where the closed shape can help you find all of the chords you need. So if you work through it, you need an E. Put your little finger on an E and it's E major. So you find your E there. Then you need a G#7. Well, I've just showed you what an A7 is. G# is a semitone below A7, so that's our A7. Our G#7 would be there, 1-1-3-2. Then we need an F# minor. Now, if you find little finger on an F#, F# is the ninth fret of the A string, down here. And then we need a minor, so this time we need our middle finger down. So there's our F#minor. A, we've already played, little finger on an A. B, little finger on a B. So there's your five shapes you need. E, G#7, F#minor, A, B. Just have a little play through those to make sure that you can see what they're doing. When I'm playing these chords, all I'm looking at is what my little finger's doing. My little finger is kind of dragging my hand around the fretboard to find those chords. And then rhythm options. I think you've got two options for this song. The first is the really simple but safe bass and strum. So just all downstrokes. You can make it quite percussive by cutting that note short. Like almost like a bluegrass chop. Or if you feel quite comfortable with all the chord shapes, you can do what I would call the country rhythm, which is where the second bass and strum of a bar is replaced by, well, you add some upstrokes, so it's this. So, bass, strum, down, up, strum, up. Bass, strum, down, up, strum. So it's very similar to bass and strum, you still have the strong notes in the same place, you just add a bit of interest in the second half of the bar. You could even do a mixture. You could do bass, you could do the country rhythm on an E chord, but a bass and strum on a G#7. Doesn't matter, you can switch between them. So now I want to have a play along with Willie Nelson's original record. I've slowed it down a little bit because this is a fast song and you can still slow me down if this is still too quick for you. So what we're going to do is we're going to play a verse, a bridge and a chorus. So you get sort of the first section, then the bridge, and then back to the first section again because the verse and chorus are the same chords. So I'm going to play along with him. I'll try and shout out the chords as they come so you know where we are. Best of luck. 1, 2, 3, 4, E. G#7. F sharp minor. A. B. E. Bridge. A. E. Back to A. Chorus, E, G#7, F# minor, A, B, there's a really nice solo on the recording that I think we can emulate on the mandolin. I think it's important to get the melody first, so let's play just a one-note melody and then we'll add the double stop. So you start here. Index finger on the 4. Second line. So if I just play that first line again, so we're starting here on the B with our first finger. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Two, three, four, same phrase. And then the last line. So the timing of that is that first measure of the last line is a bit weird. So, da, 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 da. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I just play those 12 bars with a metronome, so you can try and play along with me, here we go. After 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 2, 3, 4, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Don't worry if you can't quite get the position shift the same as me, or even the timing the same. You know, it's, I mean, Willie Nelson, notorious for doing his own interpretation of timing. So it's more of a general guide as to what the melody would be. If you wanted to turn that into an advanced version of it, we can add some difficult double stops. So I won't go through the theory. There's plenty of other mandolin lessons around on double stops. So I'm just presenting you how to play it. So if I take you through each phrase, so we start here. So I'm actually adding double stops over the melody, which is quite unusual. And when it comes to double stops, it's whatever finger can get you there. So I can do that 2 and 6 reach with my index and ring. Because then my pinky finger can get the 2 and 7. So if I play this first line slowly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So the melody's still there, I'm just adding. I'm adding some notes above. And then the second line. So I'm almost anchoring that 3. 2, 3, 4, 1. So you can see that's actually not double, so it's more of a drone of that 3. And then the last line. So 2 and 6 to start, and then. And then for this last phrase, you want to end up with index and middle on the 6 and 7. if I play the last line. 2, 3, 4. 2, 3. So if I do the same exercise, I will play along with the metronome and I'll add the chords as well so you can hear it in context. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 2, 3, 4, 1. So that's everything you'd need for On the Road Again by the great Willie Nelson. Hope we've done you proud. You can just head over and play along with his original because he plays this in E. You've got your chords, you've got your chord shapes, you've got your rhythm. The lyric sheet, if you prefer reading chords above lyrics, is included in the PDF as well. And you've also got yourself a really difficult double stop mandolin solo to go over where he plays a guitar solo. I hope you've enjoyed this brief, quick run through one of my favourite songs. If you have liked this lesson, there's loads of more lessons over at mandolmike.com. We send these out every month, and please hit like and subscribe while you're here. And we'll see you next month.